G'day viewers, Sean from Blue Wire Automotive. In this episode, if you love classic BMW, you've got to check out Julie Fenech's E21 race car.
I'm part of Team Fenech Racing, and this is my race car, Nogue. She is a 1982 BMW E21, and she's a little bit special because she's an American left-hand drive girl down under. Found her in Sydney. There was a professor that actually brought her over and did the lemons in her, and he moved, so he had to sell her, and I went to buy a roll cage and came back with a car. Well, I got her as a rolling chassis, so I've added the body kit, painted her, got donated the running gear, which was awesome. We've had to do the shocks, the exhaust, everything. Basically, it was just a shell, rolling shell on wheels. I had to build it up. I do sprints and regularities down at the Malala track and at the Bend, which is always quite an experience and a fun day to do both of them. Well, it's been a team effort, like anything. I've had Blue Wire help me with wiring, I've had Gritty Race and Resto help me upgrade the head to make it a 2.7 stroker instead of just a normal M20. I've had Tarsia help me, with tyres. Lots of people. My son, for helping me paint it. He was the one that came up with the design inspired by Ken Block's Mustang, the Hoonigan. I know it's dumb as it sounds, but all them Forza games and everything like that you played, and you get to play in Ken Block's car, and they're all left-hand drive. So it was kind of like, when I got her, a lot of it just kind of suddenly made sense, because me and Perrin been watching him and playing his games and driving his cars in simulation, fair enough. But yeah, it just kind of like made sense one day when I jumped in her, and it was like, it just all came together. It was quite, it was definitely an inspiration. But yeah, have a lot of fun with her. Went to Red Saturnats, took a drag racing. It's up against this Datsun, which my son has won, and I thought, oh yeah, I'm going to beat you, boy. And got off the line, never done drag race before, I didn't know what the lights meant. Sean's telling me while I'm racing. And got off first gear, snapped CV in second. But at least I can say I've tried it. Well, 2022 was quite an amazing year for me, because I got mentioned in Street Machine for being, one of the top 10 cool cars at Red Saturnats that got spotted at the Maccas. And then I got nominated being one of the top 10 inspirational women in Australia in motorsport, and was part of this Street Ignition Queens calendar. And then I got asked to be Iron Maiden in Street Machine, which was a huge honour, considering it's a Euro car, just not something that happens very often, so that was mega huge. And I actually came second in the BMW Challenge with our club, which was just amazing. And it was a tough challenge, I can tell you that. But yeah, just crazy year. Oh, I'd say mega challenges was getting the Roundy O2 together in 6 weeks, ready for Red Saturnats, which was amazing, because then I actually won a presentation for best street presented rally car, so that was huge. And mishaps, Every day there's a mishap. That's racing life. There's something goes wrong, whether you pop a valve, you pop a hose, you pop a plug, you pop a fuse, you pop a line, you pop a wheel. Anything can happen. Well, I'm a BMW girl through and through. And currently, I have 321s. Now I have the race car, I have an E21 Bauer, and I have a really early 1978 E21 Series 1 little red M10. It's just so much fun to drive at the moment. I still would love to do the AGL Adelaide Rally, but yeah, that would be next level. I would love to do Targa Tasmania, but this year's goal would be to do Bathurst. Yeah, baby, that would be huge too. Globally, I'd love to go and drive the Nangberg track. That would just be phenomenal. And I'd love to go drifting up that mountain in Japan, but yeah, I'd probably kill myself, so I'd have to get someone to take me. I reckon that would be mental. The sticker in the front, yeah, that's German. Bier mich, bite me. The paint, me and Perrin did that in the front yard, like true backyardigans. You know, this car has been built on a tap water budget. So, rattle canned, inspired by the Hoonicorns can blocks with the matte black to the gloss black with the stripes down the side. Whacked on a Group B body kit, so it's nice and fatness. The wheels were running, 15x8s on the front, 15x10s on the back. Big, fat, heavy wheels. I do run semi-slicks, and I do have wet slicks, for obvious reasons. It's got custom coilovers all the way around, which was absolutely brilliant, thanks to GIR. It's got Holden VT front brakes and E30 rear brakes. So the brakes have all been upgraded. You know, if you're going to go faster, you need to be able to stop harder. As you can see, there's a sneaky side exhaust outlet there. And then as we get to the boot, we've got a 55 litre fuel cell, and that's where the electronic fuel pump is set up as well. The rear quarter windows have all been replaced in Perspex for lightness. And then as we get to the inside, we've got SAS seats, pop-off Momo steering wheel. You can see some custom-made alley door cards. All the custom console with a blue wire racing loom and all switches, which is absolutely brilliant. Got an oil regulator in the back with the battery set up behind the seat for a good balance of the car. Our four-point harness setup. And a mad racing mirror, which is goes the whole length. And everything works. Indicators, wipers, and none of it has caught on fire when I've gone to turn right with the indicator on.
Common in BMW?
It's an ongoing gag. You see, I get sent so many memes of BMWs on fire about the indicator, and it's like, yeah. Now to the fun stuff. Now, she's an M20 engine that has been stroked to a 2.7. Changed the head on it to a 371, so it's a bit more peppy top end. We've added a lighter flywheel and a racing, more durable clutch setup. And at the moment, I've just put in a 260 5-speed get drag, which was good because currently she had one before, so it made it so easier because I didn't have to go bashing out the tunnels. She's got a 2.5-inch mandrel exhaust system, which is the sneaky pop-out that you've seen earlier. And she's running an LS diff center, so which has helped with a lot of traction and less likely to go popping CVs until I find better ones, and then I can go drag racing. And lots of other quirky stuff. I mean, seriously, how long have you got? That's just this car.
pump it up while your feet are stumping and the jam is pumping. Look ahead, the crowd is jumping. Pump it up a little more, get the party going on the dance floor. See, 'cause that's where the party's at, and you find out if you do that.